Hi, I'm standing here with Mark, Director of Industry Marketing for Media Entertainment with Autodesk. Hi, Mark.
Hi. Welcome to SIGGRAPH 2016.
Thank you so much. And for our users who don't already know this, Autodesk is our official sponsor this year for our coverage of SIGGRAPH. So we're very, very excited about that. Mark, how has your SIGGRAPH been so far? It just opened.
Yeah, it's just starting, so the feet aren't too sore yet, and we haven't talked ourselves out, but it's good. Everybody loves SIGGRAPH. It's a great show.
Yeah, it's absolutely a great show. With everything kind of available through the internet these days, why is it so important for people to still come to shows like this, you know, and have that back and forth in person?
Well, I do think it's changed. You know, many years ago, we would have a large booth and do product demonstrations and really show people how our software worked, because was the only way you could find out. I think what's great about a show like SIGGRAPH today, though, is we still come and do things like our Vision Series, where we bring everyone from our top customers to talk about how they work and what they do to our developers who talk about, you know, what their vision is for things like, you know, future technology, like what we see as cloud services and how that impacts our products. So I think, you know, I think SIGGRAPH is super important to the industry. And I'm kind of, you know, it's things like the Vision Series are a lot more interesting than a standard product demo, and we still put all of that out there online. You can find tons of demos and things, but, you know, you come to a show like this to really meet, greet, interact with people that are really, you know, setting the future of creating entertainment technology.
Absolutely. One thing I've noticed just being here for a short period so far is that there's a lot of exclusive things going on that people have access to and wide variety of resources. So moving on to updates for Maya and Max, this is something our members will definitely want to hear more about. So what is it that you're showcasing this year?
Well, we've got a lot of news. I think probably the biggest news is that we've announced Maya 2017. It's been a while. People have been saying, when's Autodesk coming out? They're excited to see it. And it's actually quite a big release. It's got a lot of features in it. And we're putting a ton of information out there. The kind of a couple areas I'll highlight, though, that I think people are going to be most excited about. One is some changes to rendering in Maya. So, you know, we acquired SolidAngle earlier this year. They make the Arnold renderer, which is really a fantastic, you know, great rendering solution. And we've included that as the default renderer inside of Maya. And this is going to be great because basically out of the box, you have the ability to render inside of Maya using Arnold. And it's the functionality of Arnold. Now, it's not a full license. Like, it's not, you know, the standalone Arnold license. But in terms of using it in Maya, you get the same great results, the same workflow. And we think people are really going to like this because, you know, it's something I think, you know, it's something people were looking forward to when they heard about the acquisition. How is this going to start working its way into the Autodesk products? Now, that said, we still support, you know, an open approach to rendering in Maya. So we're not going to make any changes to stop you from using whatever renderer you want. We just think that, you know, having Arnold there is a great way for us to, you know, keep Maya competitive, again, an out-of-the-box solution. But, you know, we want people to render, we want people to make great-looking pictures using Maya, and this is just a way to ensure that they have it in the software, but whatever they choose, we'll support it.
I'm sure they'll be very pleased to have that, yeah, as a new resource available to them. That's very cool. What about Max?
Yeah, so for 3ds Max, now we introduced the Max 2017 version back in April. So they had their big, you know, version update earlier this year. But we do have some news again around rendering, which is that SolidAngle is making an official plugin to support Arnold, to allow Arnold to render from Max. Which, now it's not being included, so we're not making, you know, there's not an update to 3ds Max, but basically if you have Arnold, you can go to the SolidAngle website, and you can download that plugin, and now you can send scenes to Arnold and render them from Max. There's a few limitations there. It's the first version of this, but we think it's going to be, you know, Max people have been asking for this for a long time, so we're happy to see it. There are a lot of people that use Max in, like, you know, for example, a VFX workflow with Houdini and Maya and other products that use Arnold, and now this means Max is able to, you know, send files to that same rendering setup. So we're excited. Yeah. Just getting started with it, you know, I think it's available today, so we can't wait to kind of see what people are doing with it, and we'll keep iterating that and getting it feature complete for soon.
That's so great.
Put it.
Yeah, so both Maya and Max users have benefited from the SolidAngle acquisition. It sounds like there's a lot of exciting things coming their way.
Definitely.
So, cool. Thank you so much, Mark.
Thank you. It's nice talking to you.
Nice talking to you, too.